This has been spoken of many, many, many times, isn't it? Experience, influence, see, this is the only thing I did with my life. I was in United States this lady comes up to me and says, I've been doing yoga for over 35 years, nothing happened to me. You just went and sat on that rock, all this happened to you. Where is the damn rock? And now the rock is becoming famous. Like, you know, for Gautama the Buddha, the Bodhi tree became more famous than the Buddha. I must tell you this experience. I was in Coimbatore many years ago, about almost 25, 30 years ago, and I go to somebody's house for lunch, and this lady says, Sadhguru, I have a Bodhi tree in my backyard. I sit and meditate under that. Can you come and bless my tree? I say, please water the tree, I will bless you. She said, no, 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 you must come and bless the tree. I thought, let me go into the backyard. I am always an outdoor man. So I walked out. Then I looked around, I did not see any Bodhi tree. There were three coconut trees, but I did not see any Bodhi tree. Then I asked her, where is the Bodhi tree? Then she takes me to one place. There is one stick which is about 6-7 feet tall with about 5 leaves. Under that she has put one stone plate and on which she sits and meditates under the Bodhi tree. I looked at this Bodhi tree and said, see, this Bodhi tree does not have much possibility. If you at least sit under the coconut tree, something could happen. Under coconut tree, things happen. Because when you're in this state, what you need is a knock on your head. So, what is the most significant influence? This is all I did in my life. From early childhood, I did not allow either family, my genetics, my social situations, the religious situation around me, political situations around me, whatever around me, I did not allow myself to be influenced by any of those things. This is why I keep repeating, I am an uneducated guru, because I refuse to be educated. To remain uneducated is not easy. Yes, sir, because from the moment you're born, everybody wants to teach you something that's not worked in their life. It's a compulsive need in adults the moment they see. You know, like when my daughter was 3.5 months old, I would drive alone with her all across India with my one hand on her, my right leg heavy. This is the time when I'm building Isha Foundation, I'm driving across the country. Every day I'm with a new family. Then I noticed everybody is desperate to teach something to her. I said, please, nobody teaches her anything. No ABC, no 1, 2, 3, no Mary had a little lamb. I don't want any of these things. Then people said, Sadhguru, you're not letting anybody teach anything. What will happen to this girl? This girl won't know even how to count her fingers. I said, I don't care if she cannot count her fingers. As long as she knows how to use her fingers, what do I care? She thinks this is a million, what's my problem? As long as she knows how to use her fingers. So, and I don't care whether Mary had a lamb or not. So, I said, nobody teach her anything. Because nobody is teaching her anything. See, it is by constantly looking down on the child, you know what is this, you know what is that, the child feels smaller and smaller and smaller. Because nobody spoke to her in those terms. She thought everybody is her friends. She's 2.5, 3 years, she thinks all the adults are her friends, she talks to them like they're her friends. By the time she's 18 months, she's fluently speaking 3 languages, very fluently. because nobody is teaching her anything, she's all ears listening to everything around her. Well, I wouldn't have sent her to school, but you know, my schedules and my travels didn't allow that. So I sent her to a school where there's least amount of schooling. One day she came back from school, she was around 13 years of age, and she was a little upset about what happened in the school. Then she comes and tells me, "You're teaching everybody so many things, you're not teaching me anything." I said, "See, I'm not known to do anything unsolicited. Now that you have come, you sit down, we'll see." I said, "See, this is all you need to know. You never look up to anybody." She looked at me like this, "What about you?" kind of look. I said, "Especially me, because if you look up to me, you will miss it completely. What will you do? Maybe take my picture and nail it on your wall. That's all you will do. You got to see me the way I am. If you see me the way I am, every moment of my life, it'll be of great significance to you. If you look up to me, you will exaggerate. Never look up to anybody, never look down on anybody. This is all. Is that all?" "That is all." See, if you look up to something, you will make up things in your mind. If you look down on somebody, you will make up nonsense in your head. If you don't do these two things, you will see everything just the way it is. If you see everything just the way it is, you will effortlessly navigate through life. This is all you have to do. Don't worry about what is significant. This is the most significant aspect of my life. I never looked up to anything, nor looked down on anything in my life. I looked at everything just the way it is. This is all you need to do. Thank you very much.